As many of you will be aware, the Roman Empire was massive. However, despite its rapid conquests and eventual size, there's one place the Romans notably never conquered. Hibernia, or Ireland as it's now known, and so the question is, why not? Well, the answer is a bit of an anticlimactic one. They weren't really that interested. You see, the Romans didn't just conquer territory for the fun of it. It was often done to subjugate neighbouring peoples who were raiding the Roman frontiers, or because there was an area that was rich in resources. Ireland during this period doesn't fit into any of those camps, with the notable exception of those in the north called the Scotii, who were well-known raiders but weren't really enough of a problem for the Romans to actually have to do anything about. You see, when Britannia was conquered by the Romans, its primary export was trouble. It required a near-constant large military garrison, and whilst the south was pacified, the north and the west were extremely troublesome. Keeping these areas under control wasn't cheap, and with the much more dangerous Caledonia to the north, travelling west didn't make much sense. That said, there have been Roman artefacts and coins found in Ireland, but determining how they got there is the difficult part. Were they leftovers from an attempted conquest, from trade, or was it the loot from returning Irish mercenaries or raiders? And here's the unsatisfying part. No one knows for sure. Does that mean that the Romans weren't interested in conquering Ireland? No, not at all. Agricola, the man who had subjugated much of Britain, had many times made his plans for the conquest of Ireland clear. He may, emphasis on the may, have travelled to there and defeated the Hibernians. What we know for certain is that Agricola crossed a body of water to do so, but no one knows what body for certain. And even if he did conquer a part of Ireland, it certainly didn't last, and it seems odd that no one at the time made a bigger deal about it. The fact is that Ireland likely wasn't seen by the Romans as worth conquering. Remember that back during the 1st to the 5th centuries, Ireland was densely forested and punctuated with bogs and scary tribes. Even had the Romans conquered Ireland, it was too politically fractured for Rome to govern effectively. Rome, when it conquered a land, would at first put indigenous people in charge of running the province under the guidance of a Roman governor. Ireland wasn't even nearly unified at this point, and it played host to hundreds of small rulers who squabbled over the island's resources. So, was that it? Rome simply ignored Ireland for the most of its existence, barring some trade? Well, maybe. Reading history from over a millennia ago isn't simple and prone to easy misreadings. However, throughout the entire life of the Roman Empire, both it and Ireland were in constant contact. This explains how Christianity made its way there in the early 5th century and began to take root, something that would have taken a lot longer had they not. And in conclusion, this is ultimately one of those questions which is quite underwhelming in its answer because, simply put, not enough information is available. What we know from written evidence is that Agricola had intended to conquer Hibernia and that it and the Roman world were in constant contact and traded regularly. And from archaeological evidence, we know that Roman artifacts have been found in Ireland, but how they got there is anyone's guess. I hope you enjoyed this episode and thank you for watching, with extra thanks to my patrons that you see on screen now. And a special thanks to James Bizanet, Party Boyko, Azarka Flash, Chris Wicker, Rob Waterhouse, Michael Reynolds, Gustav Swan, Maggie Paxkowski, Winston Kaywood, Riffael, Adam Harvey, Anthony Beckett, Sky Chappelle, and the Amusement Park Archives.